This is the your port URLs that you can call the port URL from out of here. So actuators, we see the actuator, the localhost machine is running, or you can check the health check, but I need to be stop the application very fast. So if I go to the here, so still its application is up and running. So you see the application is up and we can check the health conditions because this is previous deployments. So I can say station up. So its application is up with the 1.2.5s. Maybe there is some record is there. So you see some application is there. So you can, everything is there. So it doesn't matter how it is. So is a role is there. This is some roles. So some roles is there. So applications, that's we are released, the last release 1.2.5 is perfect to work. And even though if you look for the database level, if I go to the contain in the database, you see some data is there. So I am here. So select the user role, but I will show you detail. The tutorial there, so we can also select some user registration. So as you see the user registration, 3 registration there, and even though we can go for the history tables, the high flyway history tables. That I already discussed really more into the previous screencast. So it's a 2 version is there. It's exactly 1.2.1.2. So that's we define into the our schemas files is here. So exactly what we expected, exactly what we deploy in the standalone jar file based deployments. Just look for the previous screencast. So that means this is the port and the networks, DB networks, and then here is the VD user registration, and the VD user registration depend on the applications after when the Docker load the PostGIS image, and then the application will link with the Spring Boot application will link the image based on the PostGIS image, and we had the dependency with that depend on the PostGIS database creations, the instance of the creations. Here the volume definitions, and this is the network definition, UMARDREF network definitions. So that means we will stop the applications, the previous one. So previous one is 20201. We will do the stop the applications. So we will do stop the control.c. So stopping the applications. So all the history informations that you put it here. Now post is stopped. So we can also post is stopped here, the applications. We see the application. We can stop this application is stopped. Remove. We can, this is a good tool. So the Docker desktop tools I found is really good tools. So you can remove with complete application, delete. No. So it's remove with complete applications, and then nothing is there. So we have to be create the new version 1.2.6. Then how can we can create? We can steal the applications. It's too many window. So what we need to be do to go, why it doesn't work, so we can stop it by forcing the stopping. Maybe we can put it the new PowerShell. We can just go for this one. So where data URL copy part. So then we can build new versions. So new version, we need to be changed the pom.xml by little bit manually. We need to be version number six. We changed it and everything is okay. We 666 applications and the compose files. We defined here the image number. Okay, let's go. And then we're perfectly working, no problems. So let's have it create the versions, new versions of MBN. Sorry, MBN clean, install or packaged, doesn't matter. Skip test, and then through, we minimize the all versions, the test cases. So it's either building the user registration 1.2.6. Still not creating the. So still building the application. Oh, let's take times. But you need to take really close look in the configuration files. But I will put everything into my Git repository. So I have a UB subgroup Git repository. You can Google it and then find that repository and download the source code and then do your jobs. So you see the new version is created what we expected. Let's have a look then in the window. So it's a build successful. So new version is created what we expected. And now we need to be changed. Like we say, okay, we already did the change. It will take that target copy and add to the container application directory, and then the very, very simple Docker files. So it's out of this Docker file, we'll create Docker image of with these versions. So let's go to the commands to be build the Docker image. CLS. So Docker build. We can put it here, T, the tag. Tag files, and then which version we need to be do. So with this here, we can say, this is our versions, that image versions, that we already have image 1.2.5, and we need to put it to 2.1.2.6. So then we can put it in versions, after that versions. We just tag it like the new versions, and then we are in the root directory, and then it will create the image out of the new release, new version. That's I said, this is the continuous integration and continuous deployment. So it's, you see, because it's the really less time, because I already have the image, the previous image. So it's really less times to create. So that's simply, it will create the image, and just simply we the base JD open JDK Java 8 base image, and then we add our jar files, our new release into the here, and in application container endpoints entry, just simply Java and jar commands to run our Spring Boot application. Very, very straightforward, very, very simple. But as I say, this is really, really professional way to handle those applications. Doesn't matter how many environments you have it, how many installation, thousands of machines, it doesn't matter. Or you install the application in the cloud platform, it's completely free. So you need to be really clear and understand how the deployment, different type of deployments, the jar-based deployments, and